You've sown it, you've grown it, you've harvested it. But how do you take your vegetable growing one step further? Easy, by saving your own seeds from this year's crops to sow next season. When you come to think about it, saving your own seed is the last word in self-sufficiency. It'll save you money, it closes the loop on your growing, but above all, it's delightfully satisfying. So here's how to do it.
Some vegetables are easier to save seed from than others. Especially suitable candidates include peas and beans, tomatoes, peppers and lettuce, which can all be saved at the same time they are harvested or very soon afterwards. Some biennial crops, such as onions, shallots, leeks, carrots, beets and chard are also worth saving, though you'll need to overwinter some plants from one season to flower and set seed the next. Avoid saving seeds from the cabbage family. These plants readily cross-pollinate with other members of the same family, so you're unlikely to get what you hoped for. The same goes for F1 hybrids, which, because they are created from two separate parent varieties, simply won't come true to type. For this reason, only ever save the seeds of traditional open-pollinated varieties.
Okay, so let's start with the easiest of the lot, peas and beans. As the end of the season approaches, leave some pods to just dry out on the plants. You can see and feel the beans swelling within the pods. They're ready to pick and collect when the pods themselves turn leathery or crisp to the touch.
You can get a lot of seeds from just a few plants, which makes saving these seeds very worthwhile indeed. Shell the pods to reveal the beans or peas inside, then discard any very small, misshapen or damaged seeds. Save only the best, clean seeds. Spread them out onto newspaper to dry out on a warm windowsill for 7 to 10 days. Fava beans or broad beans can cross-pollinate with other varieties, so only save seeds from these beans if you are growing just one variety.
Lettuces produce literally hundreds of seeds per plant. You may find you need to stake the plant as it stretches out to flower. This lettuce is coming along nicely, but it probably has a few more days to go before it's really full of the fluffy seed heads. Once it is, I'll lift it out of the ground and hang it upside down to continue drying indoors. Then, after a couple of weeks, it's simply a question of rubbing the seed heads between the palms of your hands to coax out the seeds.
As for any vegetable, it's important to choose the very best plants to collect seed from. This way you'll actively select for those plants that perform the strongest and are best suited to the conditions in your garden.
The seeds of tomatoes and chilies are ready when the fruits themselves are good for eating, so these chili peppers will need to ripen to red before I collect the seeds from them.
Once they're ready, simply scrape away the seeds from the pith, then spread the seeds out onto paper to dry out for a week or more before storing.
This tomato's ready, but before drying and storing the seeds, the pulp from around them must first be removed. This isn't difficult, but there is a specific process to do it correctly. It's all explained in our video on the topic, and you can find a link to it in the video description below.
Onions, leeks, and shallots set seed in their second year. These plants cross-pollinate, so you'll need to overwinter more than one plant of the same variety to flower the following season. The flowers are beautiful though, and provide welcome food for local bees and other pollinators.
The seed heads are ready once they have dried out and can be flaked into a bag for cleaning and sorting. But if you need the space, you can hurry things along by cutting them a little bit earlier. But first, check that the seeds in the seed pod are ready. Open it up. And if the seeds are black, you're good to go.
Leave the seed heads to dry out in a warm, well-ventilated place such as a greenhouse. Once they've turned a straw colour, simply rub the seed heads between your fingers to release the seeds. Dry seeds can be cleaned before storing by carefully blowing away any remaining chaff, or separating out the seeds through a series of screens or sieves. Seeds should be stored in paper envelopes labelled with the variety and the date. Store them somewhere cool, dry and dark until you're ready to sow in the spring.
Saving your own seeds from these vegetables isn't challenging, and it's amazing how many seeds you can get from just a few plants. Now, if you save your own seeds, we'd love to hear your top tips for doing so. So don't be shy, drop us a comment below. And sow the seeds for your own success too by subscribing to our video channel if you haven't already done so. I'll catch you next time.